Good morning to all the students who are present and welcome to the session. In this session, I am going to discuss some questions that are based on photoelectric laws of emission. So, if you have studied all the laws, then good. If you have not studied, then I will discuss here in the beginning and after that we will see the questions. So, background color is changed from today onwards. I will use a black color because it will the colors will enhance in this background. Okay, so that's why I have selected this background now. So hope you will like this background. And okay, so before starting the video, you have to know three things. First thing is that the total energy of photon is equal to work function. This is the Einstein's photoelectric equation. Total energy of a photon is equal to work function plus kinetic energy of photons. I have given one example in the earlier video in the introduction of photoelectric effect that suppose the total energy is 1000. Suppose the 1000 is the total energy and the work function is 200 joules. So 200 joule is the work function. Incident energy of photon is 1000 joules. So 200 is the work function. So what will be rest of the energy used? So rest of the energy is used for kinetic energy. That means what amount of energy approximately भी क्या बचे exactly ही आएगा वैसे. So 800 joule is used to accelerate the photoelectrons that are emitted from the metal surface. So more will be the incident energy. Now see, more will be the energy of incident photon, more will be the kinetic energy. This term is constant, now this 200 is basically constant. So if we remove this 200, then we can simply say kinetic energy of photoelectron is directly proportional to incident energy. Isko bache EI likh lete hain. We can write it as EI, that is incident energy. And this incident energy is equal to H into mu, where mu is the frequency. So that I will discuss later, but first of all you have to understand that more will be the kinetic energy because this work function is constant. This term is work function is constant. So suppose 1600, let's suppose 1600 is the incident energy. Then in that case, kinetic energy will be equal to 1400. Suppose incident energy is equal to 2000. Suppose the incident energy is equal to 2000 and work function is 200. In that case, kinetic energy will be what? Kinetic energy will be 1800 joule. So more will be the incident energy, more will be the kinetic energy. First thing, incident energy more, kinetic energy more. Now see the second thing. You can note down these all points. These are not related to question number 1. These are simple information. I will discuss question number 1 later on. You can note down this all things. Okay, now see. We have studied that kinetic energy is directly proportional to, or you can say kinetic energy is directly proportional to incident energy, that is EI. And EI is equal to, now see, EI is equal to H into mu, where mu is the frequency term, where mu is the frequency of incident radiation. Or you can write it as EI, EI also equal to H into, where H is the Planck's constant, so H into C by lambda. So what do you have to understand from here? What you have to understand that kinetic energy ऑफ फोटो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू नाउ सी, डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू ई आई, दैट मीन्स डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू फ्रीक्वेंसी. सो एच इज कॉन्स्टेंट, सो दैट मीन्स कनेटिक एनर्जी इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द इंसिडेंट फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड इट इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू वेवलेंथ. सो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस रिलेशन वी विल यूज इन दिस फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन कि कनेटिक एनर्जी डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल है फ्रीक्वेंसी के एंड इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल है वेवलेंथ के. यू कैन नोट डाउन दीज टू पॉइंट्स प्लीज नोट डाउन इन योर नोटबुक. आई होप इट इज क्लियर नाउ. द सेकेंड थिंग इज दैट स्टूडेंट्स, वन फोटोन ऑफ लाइट विल एमिट वन इलेक्ट्रॉन. सो दैट मीन्स इफ लेट्स सपोज, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट ओनली वन फोटोन ऑफ लाइट विल एमिट वन इलेक्ट्रॉन. सो लेट्स सपोज वर्क फंक्शन इज एटी एंड वर्क फंक्शन इज 80 एंड एनर्जी ऑफ वन फोटोन इज 60. सो एनर्जी ऑफ वन फोटोन इज 60 बट रिक्वायर्ड वर्क फंक्शन इज 80 जाउल. सो दैट मीन्स दिस फोटोन कैनॉट इजेक्ट इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्रॉम द सर्फेस. बट नाउ टेक लेट्स टेक टू फोटोन्स. कैन टू फोटोन्स एमिट दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन? कैन टू फोटोन्स विल रिमूव वन इलेक्ट्रॉन? नो स्टूडेंट्स, ओनली वन फोटोन इज अलाउड टू रिमूव द वन इलेक्ट्रॉन. सो लेट्स दैट मीन्स इफ नंबर ऑफ फोटोन्स इंक्रीज दैट विल नॉट इंक्रीज द कनेटिक एनर्जी. कनेटिक एनर्जी इज डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द वन फोटोन. कनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ वन इलेक्ट्रॉन यू स्टूडेंट्स, दीज आर द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स दैट यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड. कनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ वन इलेक्ट्रॉन इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द कनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ वन फोटोन. एनर्जी ऑफ वन फोटोन ओनली, वन फोटोन हियर. ऐसा नहीं है कि 10 फोटोन आ गए और एक इलेक्ट्रॉन को एमिट कर गए और उसको एक्सेलरेट कर गए. सो ओनली वन फोटोन विल एक्सेलरेट वन इलेक्ट्रॉन. आई होप नाउ इट इज क्लियर कि ऑन इंक्रीजिंग द इंटेंसिटी आई एम राइटिंग IN फॉर इंटेंसिटी. ऑन इंक्रीजिंग द इंटेंसिटी द कनेटिक एनर्जी विल नॉट चेंज. सो कनेटिक एनर्जी इज डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ रेडिएशन ओनली. सो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ आई एम राइटिंग सम पॉइंट्स कनेटिक एनर्जी अबाउट द कनेटिक एनर्जी आई एम राइटिंग सम पॉइंट्स. सो यू कैन नोट डाउन दीज पॉइंट्स. कनेटिक एनर्जी इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू इंसिडेंट रेडिएशन फ्रीक्वेंसी. कनेटिक एनर्जी इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू वन बाय लैम्डा, इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द वेवलेंथ. वन बाय तो बोल ही दिया, इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल. एंड कनेटिक एनर्जी डज नॉट डिपेंड को बच्चे कैसे लिखेंगे, यहाँ पे लिख ही लेते हैं डज नॉट डिपेंड. ओके, कनेटिक एनर्जी डज नॉट, दीज आर आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द कनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ फोटो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. डिपेंड ऑन इंटेंसिटी, सो यहाँ पे IN लिखा है. अच्छे, कनेटिक एनर्जी डज नॉट डिपेंड अपॉन इंटेंसिटी. इंटेंसिटी का पॉइंट क्लियर हो गया होगा आई थिंक, आपको होना चाहिए. अगर नहीं क्लियर है तो एक बार पूछ लेना बाद में. सो दीज आर द पॉइंट्स दैट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द कनेटिक एनर्जी कंसेप्ट. वैन एवर द फोटो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर एमिटेड, हाउ डज द कनेटिक एनर्जी विल चेंज. सो कनेटिक एनर्जी इज डिपेंडिंग ऑन द फ्रीक्वेंसी. मोर विल बी द फ्रीक्वेंसी, मोर विल बी द कनेटिक एनर्जी. इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू वेवलेंथ, दैट मीन्स लेसर विल बी द वेवलेंथ, मोर विल बी द कनेटिक एनर्जी. एंड इट डज नॉट डिपेंड अपॉन इंटेंसिटी. दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट कनेटिक एनर्जी डज नॉट डिपेंड अपॉन द इंटेंसिटी. ओके, सो दीज आर द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स. एंड नाउ वी हैव टू सी द फोटो इलेक्ट्रिक करंट. सो फोटो इलेक्ट्रिक करंट दैट इज ऑन हेयर रिटन I. सो I इज डिपेंडिंग ऑन number of photons. Students, suppose, what do you mean by I? I is the number of electrons emitted, per unit time. And that number of electrons is depending on what? Suppose incident photon kitne hai? 1 incident photon. Then in the second case 10 incident photon. This is 10. In the first case 1 incident photon. So in which case the energy will be more? You can easily observe. In which case current will be more? In this case 1 electron will be emitted. In this case how many electrons will be emitted? 10 electrons will be emitted if the each photon has the sufficient energy. So on increasing the intensity, this is the intensity increase. Number of photons increase means intensity increase. So number of photon increase karne ka matlab hai bache ki intensity ko increase kar dena. Intensity means ki jitne incident radiations hai unko matlab particles ko increase kar dena. That is called intensity increase. So that means we can conclude that on increasing the intensity, I am writing IN for it, the current will increase. So current I, that is photoelectric current, is directly proportional to the intensity of light, intensity of photons or intensity of the incident light. Now see, if I change the frequency, does the current change? If I change the frequency, let's suppose work function is 100. 100 is means 100 is the energy. Okay, and I incident 4 electrons. 100 is what? 100 is work function. I can write here so that you can understand. 100 is the work function, and this is energy. You can see work function is 100, energy is 200. Let's suppose first case. And 4 electrons will be emitted, obviously. Work function is 100, energy is incident energy of 1 photon is 200. So 4 photons are incidenting, that means 4 electrons will be emitted. I hope this is clear. I am repeating again. 100 is the work function of metal. Total energy of 1 photon is 200. How many photons are incidenting? 4. So 4 photons of energy 200 are incidenting, that means work function is 100, so 4 electrons will be emitted. Now see the second case. In the second case I am assuming that this energy is changed, this energy is now 400, but the incident photons are still 4. So 400 is the energy, incident photons are 4. In this case how many electrons will be emitted? In this case also 4 electrons will be emitted, because 1 photon will emit 1 electron. 1 photon can eject 1 electron. So that means the intensity, the photoelectric current, this current I is not depending on, this photoelectric current is not depending on the intensity. This is depending on the this does not depend on the frequency, because energy kab change ho rahi hai? Energy of incident radiation is changing with respect to frequency or wavelength. So that means photoelectric current is not changing with respect to incident frequency change or wavelength change. Wavelength ko change kar do, frequency ko change kar do, current change nahi hoga. But when we change this number of photons, if I change this number of photons to 8, अगर मैं यहाँ पे change कर देता हूँ photons को, तब electrons emit ज़्यादा होंगे, क्योंकि photons increase हो गए, और photons क्या करेंगे, जितने number of photons होंगे, almost उतने ही electron emit होंगे, अगर सभी के पास sufficient energy होगी. So that means when I increase the intensity, in that case, current will increase. तो उस case में current increase होगा. So now you have to note down some points about current. So about the photoelectric current, I am writing some points. It is directly proportional to intensity of the light. It is directly proportional to the intensity of the incident light. I hope this is clear. And it does not depend upon. Now we have to write it does not depend upon. Students, I will start the questions. Wait. This does not depend. तो डिपेंड नहीं कर रहा, इनवर्सली करे या जैसे मर्जी करे, हमें उससे कोई नहीं है. सो इट डज नॉट डिपेंड ऑन टू फैक्टर्स दैट आर फ्रीक्वेंसी, इंसिडेंट फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड लैम्डा. स्टूडेंट्स, यू कैन नोट डाउन दीज पॉइंट्स प्लीज. दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट करंट इज फोटो इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इज डिपेंडिंग ऑन द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ रेडिएशन, इंटेंसिटी ऑफ द light, and it does not depend upon the two factors that are frequency and wavelength. So frequency and wavelength ke upar photoelectric current does not depend. So up to this point we have studied about the photoelectric current characteristics ke uske kya rules hain and kinetic energy ke kya rules hain. So now we are going to start the questions. I will do 5 questions here. That 5 questions will contain 3 questions each. तो तीन रिलेशन होंगे, इंटेंसिटी का लिखेंगे, फ्रीक्वेंसी का लिखेंगे एंड वेवलेंथ का लिखेंगे. ओके, सो नाउ विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी टाइम लेट्स मूव टू द सेशन क्वेश्चंस. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन ऑन स्क्रीन इज दिस इज आई सॉरी दिस इज फ्रीक्वेंसी 1, दिस इज फ्रीक्वेंसी 2, दिस इज फ्रीक्वेंसी 3 एंड दिस इज फ्रीक्वेंसी 4. So see in which case kinetic energy is more. In this case kinetic energy of photoelectrons, kinetic energy of emitted photoelectrons is maximum, and for these three cases the kinetic energy is same. So that means mu 1, students you can note down this one, mu 1 is greater than mu 2. This is the frequency relation. Mu 1 is greater than mu 2 equal to mu 3 equal to mu 4. Students, why this relation is this one? Like ये ऐसे क्यों आया? Because you can see here, from this expression we can see kinetic energy is constant for these three incident radiations. Therefore, radiation 2, for radiation 3, for radiation 4, and kinetic energy for 1 is maximum. तो इसके लिए ज़्यादा है तो frequency के directly proportional थी kinetic energy. More will be the kinetic energy, more will be the frequency. So frequency 1 की ज़्यादा होगी, that's why इसकी kinetic energy ज़्यादा है, और जिनकी same है उनकी frequency same होगी. So that means this will be the relation mu 1 greater than mu 2. ठीक है, तो mu 2 से तो greater ही होगी क्योंकि इसके पास kinetic energy कम है frequency 2 के पास, एंड जितनी 2 के पास है उतनी ही 3 के पास है, उतनी ही 4 के पास है. दैट मीन्स frequency 2 इज इक्वल टू frequency 3 एंड frequency 3 इज इक्वल टू frequency 4. सो दिस विल बी द रिलेशन फॉर द frequency. अच्छा, नोट कर लेना frequency के लिए ये रिलेशन बनेगा आपका. यू कैन नोट डाउन दिस रिलेशन फॉर द क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, frequency relation, this one. Frequency relation, you can note down. I hope you have noted this one. So now moving to the wavelength relation. I hope noted clear. Okay, so now I am going to clear this one. Now see second one. Now I am writing the relation for the wavelength. Wavelength is lambda. Okay, so I am not writing complete thing here. Now see the wavelength. Students, this is having the maximum energy. This is having the maximum energy. Now wavelength energy is inversely proportional to kinetic energy is depending on the energy. Kinetic energy is depending on the incident energy, and incident energy is inversely proportional to wavelength. That means जिसकी पास kinetic energy उसकी ज़्यादा होगी जिसकी इंसिडेंट रेडिएशन ज़्यादा होगी, और इंसिडेंट रेडिएशन किसकी ज़्यादा होगी जिसकी वेवलेंथ कम होगी. बेसिकली बच्चे फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड रिलेशन बिटवीन फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड द फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड वेवलेंथ इज ऑपोजिट. सो दैट मीन्स इफ फ्रीक्वेंसी वन इज मोर देन फ्रीक्वेंसी टू. इन केस ऑफ लैम्डा वन, दिस इज लैम्डा वन, सो लैम्डा वन विल बी लेस देन लैम्डा टू. दिस विल बी द रिलेशन बच्चे. लैम्डा वन की वैल्यू लैम्डा टू से छोटी होगी बिकॉज इट हैज़ मोर काइनेटिक एनर्जी. तो काइनेटिक एनर्जी मीन्स इसके पास इंसिडेंट एनर्जी भी ज़्यादा होगी. इंसिडेंट एनर्जी कब ज़्यादा होगी? व्हेन इंसिडेंट एनर्जी विल बी मोर व्हेन इसके पास वेवलेंथ कम होगी. सो दैट मीन्स लैम्डा वन इज लेस देन लैम्डा टू इज इक्वल टू लैम्डा थ्री. लैम्डा थ्री बिकॉज दिस थ्री हैव द नाउ सेम एनर्जी, इनके पास सेम एनर्जी है. सो दिस विल बी इक्वल टू लैम्डा फोर. सो स्टूडेंट्स दिस विल बी द रिलेशन फॉर द वेव लेंथ. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर. आई एम रिपीटिंग अगेन बच्चे, लैम्डा वन के पास सबसे ज़्यादा काइनेटिक एनर्जी है, दैट मीन्स लैम्डा वन के पास सबसे कम वेव लेंथ होगी. सो लैम्डा वन विल बी लेस दैन लैम्डा टू. नाउ लैम्डा टू थ्री फोर विल बी सेम बिकॉज दिस थ्री हैव द सेम काइनेटिक एनर्जी. तो इनके पास काइनेटिक एनर्जी सेम है, दैट मीन्स इनके पास वेवलेंथ सेम होगी. सो लैम्डा वन लेस देन लैम्डा टू इक्वल टू लैम्डा थ्री इक्वल टू लैम्डा फोर. सो दिस विल बी द रिलेशन फॉर द वेवलेंथ. यू कैन नोट डाउन स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द रिलेशन फॉर वेवलेंथ. This is the relation for the wavelength. I hope this is clear. And thank you so much. If you are liking this video, if you feel that this video will be useful to you, then you can like and share this video with your friends. This is the relation for wavelength. Now we have to see the relation for intensity for this question. After that, we will move to question number 2. So students, I hope you have noted down the relation for the wavelength. Now we are going to move to intensity relation. Intensity relation ka students hum karenge calculate from the current. So now see intensity I1. Students, current, photoelectric current for these two. I1 and I2 are same, so that means I1. Wait. That means I1 is equal to I2. So in dono ki value to same hogi because these two radiations having the same photoelectric current. So maximum current we have to see. So I1 equal to I2. Now see I3. I3 bache kya hai, intensity kam hogi because it has less current. So that means I2 is greater than I3 की वैल्यू स्मॉलर होगी ना I2 से. सो दैट मीन्स I2 इज ग्रेटर देन I3 एंड देन I4. सो I4 की उससे भी ज़्यादा कम होगी, दैट मीन्स I3 इज ग्रेटर देन I4. सो दिस इज द रिलेशन फॉर द इंटेंसिटी स्टूडेंट्स. आई होप यू हैव लिसन्ड मी केयरफुली. If you are any doubt is there, then you can ask me in the comment box or you can drop a personal message on this number for any query or any related query, any feedback for any suggestion. I will be available there. You can drop a message instead of call. So I hope this is clear now. This expression is clear to you all. Okay, how this is change relation is changed. I1, why I1 is equal to I2? Because I am repeating, because photoelectric current for these two radiations are same. That means I1 will be equal to the intensity of radiation 1 is equal to intensity of radiation 2. So these, that means intensity of 1 and 2 are same. After that you can see here, intensity of third radiation will be less because it has some less current. So that means I2 is greater than I3 and further I4 is less than I3, so that means we can write I3 greater than I4. So this is the relation of intensity. I am writing here, you can note down until us time mein aap record note kar le. This is the relation for intensity. Students, I have changed the background color as well as some font size also. So if you like this one, you can okay, you can give your suggestions ki you are liking this way background or not. So this is all about the intensity. Okay, so I hope it is clear. Relation for intensity is clear. I1 equal to I2, intensity of radiation 1 equal to intensity of radiation 2, greater than I3, greater than I4. So I hope you have noted down. But I am pausing this, you can note down. So we have done the question number 1. For 3 terms we have find, firstly we have found find the relation for frequency, then we have calculated the relation for wavelength, then we have calculated the relation for intensity of the radiation. If this question is clear, then we can move to question number 2 now. Okay, so now we are moving to the question number 2 that is on screen. Okay, on screen. Students, in this question we will consume less time because now concept is clear to you. So firstly see the kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is same for all the three radiations. So that means firstly if I have to write the frequency relation, then frequency relation will be mu 1 equal to mu 2 equal to mu 3, because these three have the same kinetic energy here. उनके पास सभी के पास same kinetic energy है, that means incident radiation की जो energy है that will be same, जैसे मैंने आपको in the beginning बताया था. So that means mu 1 is equal to mu 2 is equal to mu 3. जिनको नहीं पता भी, जिन्होंने बीच में से कहीं start की हो video, so total energy is equal to work function. मैंने पहले भी बताया था, जिनको नहीं पता they can clear. Work function plus kinetic energy. Work function is constant and incident energy, that kinetic energy is depending on the incident energy. So here you can see work function is a constant term. Work function is constant term है, so kinetic energy is directly depending on the incident radiation. जितनी ज़्यादा incident की energy होगी उतनी ही ज़्यादा kinetic energy होगी. So kinetic energy, now kinetic energy is same for 3, that means incident radiation is same. And incident radiation is same, that means incident frequency is same. So these things you have to know. And I hope it is clear almost everyone. सभी को clear हो गया होगा, कहीं doubt है. Then बच्चे you can ask me, and this is Jaskirat here. And at this end, Jaskirat here. And I hope this is clear now. And okay. Wait. I hope this is clear and this is the relation for frequency. Students, this is the relation for frequency. You can note down the relation. Then we will discuss the next part. This is the relation for frequency. I hope you have noted down. Okay, now we have to see the relation for intensity. See, for radiation 1, the current is maximum, the photoelectric current is maximum for radiation 1, then for 2, and then for 3. That means intensity in this case is changing, intensity is not constant. So intensity is changing. Now we have to write the intensity relation. So intensity of radiation 1, bachche abhi hamari wavelength ka bhi reh gaya, chalo koi na, intensity of radiation 1 is greater than intensity of radiation 2. Intensity of radiation 1 is greater than intensity of radiation 2, and intensity of radiation 2 is greater than radiation 3. So I hope this is clear. You can note down. From here you can see intensity of radiation 1 is greater than intensity of radiation 2, greater than intensity of radiation 3. Because यहाँ पे current क्या है, current is changing here, current is not constant, current is changing here. So when photoelectric current is changing, then that means there is change in the intensity. तो वहाँ कहीं intensity में change है. So that means I1 is greater than I2, greater than I3, and this is the relation for intensity. Students, इस type के exams में बहुत से question देखने को मिलते हैं. इन द एंट्रेंस एग्जाम्स एज वेल एज बोर्ड एग्जाम्स, कई बार इस टाइप के क्वेश्चंस मिलते हैं. सो दिस इज द रिलेशन फॉर इंटेंसिटी, दिस इज द रिलेशन फॉर द इंटेंसिटी. आई होप इट इज क्लियर. यू कैन नोट डाउन बच्चे, इफ यू हैव नोट डाउन देन यू कैन नोट डाउन दिस रिलेशन, रिलेशन फॉर द इंटेंसिटी. ओके, नाउ वन रिलेशन इज लेफ्ट, दैट इज ऑफ वेवलेंथ, बट दैट इज क्लियर टू यू. ओके, आई थिंक आपको सुनना चाहिए क्लियर. पॉज द वीडियो एंड राइट द रिलेशन फॉर द वेवलेंथ. प्लीज पॉज द वीडियो. हाँ, प्लीज पॉज द वीडियो एंड नोट डाउन द राइट डाउन द रिलेशन फॉर वेवलेंथ. ओके, आई होप यू हैव नोटेड डाउन, आपने नोट लिखा होगा. सो नाउ एनर्जी इज सेम, दैट मीन्स kinetic energy is same, that means incident energy will be same, that means lambda will be also same. So lambda and frequency का relation बच्चे almost जहाँ पे sign change होंगे या फिर अगर equal है तो equal ही रहेगा. जैसे frequency 1 was equal to frequency 2 equal to frequency 3, so in this case lambda 1 will be equal to lambda 2 equal to lambda 3. सो दिस इज़ द रिलेशन फॉर लैम्डा. जिनको समझ आ गया अच्छी बात है, जिनको नहीं आया दे कैन आस्क मी द कमेंट इन द कमेंट बॉक्स योर क्वायरीज. लैम्डा वन विल बी इक्वल टू लैम्डा टू इक्वल टू लैम्डा थ्री. स्टूडेंट्स यू कैन नोट डाउन दिस वन अगेन, एंड दिस इज़ द रिलेशन फॉर वेवलेंथ, दिस इज़ द रिलेशन फॉर वेवलेंथ. I hope it is clear. If you like this video, you found this video is useful to you, then you can write in the comment box or you can drop me a message, and please like and share this channel with your friends, and thank you so much for that. Noted. Now we are going to move to the question number 3. So question number 3 is on screen. Kinetic energy on this axis. Sometimes bache yahan pe hame wo bhi milega on this axis. On this kinetic energy axis, we will find stopping potential. We will find sometimes यहाँ पे stopping potential भी मिलेगा. Because kinetic energy and stopping potential are directly proportional. We will see वो भी मिलेगा आपको कहीं पे. Kinetic energy की जगह V naught भी हो सकता है students. Because kinetic energy is equal to E into V naught, where V naught is the stopping potential. तो इसके बारे में भी बात होगी, अगर आपको भी पता है तो ठीक है. सो कहीं पे kinetic energy की जगह पे V naught भी लिखा हो सकता है, but on the y axis आपको current ही given होगा. So on this axis you will get definitely current. On this axis यहाँ पे kinetic energy भी हो सकती है, as well as V naught can be also there, which is the stopping potential. So you can try this question. I hope we have done 2 questions, and in the earlier video also we have done some questions. So now I is on this axis. Firstly write the relation for frequency. So for frequency let's write the relation. Kinetic energy is same for these first and second radiation, for third it is kinetic energy is less, that means frequency 1 is equal to frequency 2. So frequency 1 is equal to frequency 2. Frequency 2 is greater than the frequency number 3. Students, I hope this is clear. The kinetic energy is same for radiation 1 and 2. So radiation 1 and 2 is here. 1 and 2. The kinetic energy is same. So if kinetic energy is same, that means incident radiation has kinetic energy same. That means जो इंसिडेंट फ्रीक्वेंसी होगी वो भी सेम होगी. सो दैट मीन्स म्यू वन इज इक्वल टू म्यू टू. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर अप टू दिस पॉइंट. क्लियर देन बच्चे देखो, कनेटिक एनर्जी फॉर रेडिएशन 3 इज लेस, दैट मीन्स इसके पास इंसिडेंट एनर्जी भी कम होगी. इफ़ इंसिडेंट एनर्जी लेस है तो दैट मीन्स इसकी फ्रीक्वेंसी भी लेस होगी. सो म्यू 3 इज लेस देन म्यू टू, सो इसको हमने ऐसे भी लिख दिया कि म्यू टू ग्रेटर देन म्यू थ्री, तो ये भी ठीक है। म्यू टू थ्री लेस देन, अगर म्यू दैट मीन्स म्यू थ्री इज लेस देन म्यू टू, सो हमने इस तरह से लिख दिया म्यू वन इक्वल टू म्यू टू इक्वल ग्रेटर देन म्यू थ्री। सो दिस इज द रिलेशन फॉर फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ द गिवन थर्ड क्वेश्चन। एनी वन हैविंग डाउट्स यू कैन आस्क, पूछ सकते हो बच्चे कहीं भी, कभी भी आपको लगता है किसी क्वेश्चन में डाउट है, माई फोन नंबर इज अवेलेबल ऑन द इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द वीडियो, स्टार्टिंग में फोन नंबर अवेलेबल है। सो यू कैन नोट डाउन द रिलेशन फॉर फ्रीक्वेंसी फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन, यू कैन नोट डाउन द रिलेशन फॉर द फ्रीक्वेंसी फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन। आई होप यू हैव नोटेड डाउन, आई होप यू हैव नोटेड डाउन। नाउ वी हैव टू मूव टू क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री सेकेंड पार्ट। नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड द वेवलेंथ रिलेशन। स्टूडेंट्स दिस फ्रीक्वेंसी, दिस कैनेटिक एनर्जी सेम, दैट मीन्स वेवलेंथ फॉर वन इज इक्वल टू वेवलेंथ फॉर सेकेंड। सो लैम्डा वन इज इक्वल टू लैम्डा टू। नाउ सी फ्रीक्वेंसी फॉर थ्री इज लेस, तो फ्रीक्वेंसी इसकी मतलब इसकी जो कैनेटिक एनर्जी है दैट इज लेस। कैनेटिक एनर्जी इज लेस जब कैनेटिक एनर्जी इन्वर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल है वेवलेंथ के। सो कैनेटिक एनर्जी कब कम होगी, जब वेवलेंथ ज़्यादा होगी। दैट मीन्स लैम्डा वन इक्वल टू लैम्डा टू लेस देन लैम्डा थ्री, तो लैम्डा थ्री की वैल्यू ज़्यादा है बच्चे। लैम्डा थ्री इज ग्रेटर देन लैम्डा टू, सो दैट मीन्स लैम्डा टू इज लेस देन लैम्डा थ्री, तो लैम्डा टू की वैल्यू छोटी होगी लैम्डा थ्री से, तभी लैम्डा थ्री ज़्यादा होगा ना। लैम्डा थ्री विल बी मोर अगर लैम्डा टू लेस होगा। सो दिस विल बी द रिलेशन फॉर वेवलेंथ बच्चे। तो फ्रीक्वेंसी के ऑपोजिट रिलेशन आएगा, उसमें आया था हमारे पास फ्रीक्वेंसी टू ग्रेटर देन फ्रीक्वेंसी थ्री, तो फ्रीक्वेंसी के ऑपोजिट रिलेशन आता है वेवलेंथ का। सो दैट मीन्स वेवलेंथ का ये रिलेशन है, दिस इज द रिलेशन फॉर वेवलेंथ। यू कैन नोट डाउन दिस वन वेवलेंथ रिलेशन, लैम्डा वन इक्वल टू लैम्डा वन इक्वल टू लैम्डा टू, एंड लैम्डा टू इज लेस देन लैम्डा थ्री, बिकॉज लैम्डा टू के पास क्या है, ज़्यादा कनेटिक एनर्जी है एज कम्पेयर टू लैम्डा थ्री। यू कैन नोट डाउन। नाउ वी आर लेफ्ट विद इंटेंसिटी। स्टूडेंट्स यू कैन नोट डाउन दिस रिलेशन आई होप, एंड नाउ वी हैव टू सी द फ्रीक्वेंसी रिलेशन फॉर द क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री। You can try also, pause the video and try. I repeat, pause the video and try please. Okay, now see this is the intensity photoelectric current and this is for 2 and 3. So that means intensity of radiation 1, current for this is more, so intensity for radiation 1 is more than intensity for radiation 2. Intensity I1 greater than I2 equal to I3 equal to I3. So this is the relation for intensity. I am repeating, you can listen. Current is maximum for first radiation, that means iski intensity sabse jyada, and current for the second and third radiation is constant. So that means intensity of 2 is equal to intensity of 3. So this is I1, intensity of radiation 1 is greater than radiation 2. Intensity for radiation 1 is greater than intensity of radiation 2 equal to the intensity of radiation 3. So this is the relation for intensity. Students, you can note down the relation. And we have completed the three questions. If you are liking the way of teaching by me, then you can like and share this video. So this is the relation for intensity for the radiation, intensity of the radiations. So I1 greater than I2 and equal to I3. I hope this is clear. So we have done three questions now. Up to this time, two questions are left in this video. And if you find this video is useful to you, then you can like and share this video. Thank you so much. And now we have to do the fourth question. Fourth question is on screen. Okay, can you do this now? Can you write the relation for the frequency? Please pause the video and try. I repeat, pause the video and try first. Okay, now see kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is same for these three radiations, 1, 2, 3. So kinetic energy for 1, 2 and 3 are same. So that means frequency 1 is equal to frequency 2 is equal to frequency 3 and frequency 3 के बाद पूछे क्या आएगा frequency 1 equal to frequency 2 equal to frequency 3 after that frequency 3 के बाद आएगा now frequency 3 will be greater than frequency 4 frequency 1 greater equal to frequency 2 equal to frequency 3 greater than frequency 4 because frequency 4 ke paas minimum kinetic energy hai, so frequency 4 is smallest. So this is the relation for frequency. Students, you can note down please again. If any doubt is there, then you can check. Kinetic energy for first radiation, second radiation and third, these three kinetic energy is same, so that means frequency 1 is equal to frequency 2 is equal to frequency 3. So up to this point frequency 1 equal to frequency 2 equal to frequency 3. Now see kinetic energy for these three radiations is more than 4, so that means this is frequency 3 is greater than 4. So iska vache directly bhi bol sakte ho frequency 2 is greater than 4, frequency 1 is greater than 4. तो इस तरह से आप directly भी लिख सकते हो. So this is the combined form frequency 1 equal to frequency 2 equal to frequency 3 greater than frequency 4. I hope you have noted down. Now find the relation for the wavelength. So lambda 1 equal to lambda 2 frequency lambda 1 equal to lambda 2 equal to lambda 3 because these three have the same incident energy. Kinetic energy is same, that means they have the same incident energy also. So lambda 1 equal to lambda 2 equal to lambda 3. Now lambda 3 ke paas jyada kinetic energy hai, so that means lambda 3 is less than lambda 4. So lambda 3 is less than lambda 4. So I hope this is clear. This is the relation for the wavelength. Students, थोड़ा सा कहीं ऊपर स्क्रीन में आ रहा होगा वाटर मार्क, तो उसको थोड़ा सा अपना कर लेना सेटिंग, ठीक है. सो लैम्डा 1 इक्वल टू लैम्डा 2 इक्वल टू लैम्डा 3 लेस देन लैम्डा 4, दिस इज द रिलेशन फॉर द वेवलेंथ. वेवलेंथ का बच्चे ये रिलेशन आया. ओके, सो दिस इज द रिलेशन फॉर द वेवलेंथ. I hope it is clear now. You can note down it in your fair notebook, please. Now we have to move to the question number. Okay, before going to question number 5, intensity relation is left. So now see the intensity. Intensity for current 1 is more, 2 se kam hai, so 3 and 4 ki common hai. So that means intensity. ओके, थोड़ा नीचे लिखते हैं बच्चे, क्योंकि यहाँ पे शायद विजिबिलिटी का कोई इशू हो. सो आई वन इज ग्रेटर देन आई टू, आई वन ग्रेटर देन आई टू, आई टू एंड ग्रेटर देन आई टू की वैल्यू भी ज़्यादा है, ग्रेटर देन आई थ्री, आई वन ग्रेटर देन आई टू ग्रेटर देन आई थ्री इक्वल टू, आई थ्री एंड आई फोर की वैल्यू सेम है बच्चे, because then current is same for I3 and I4. So I3 is equal to I4. I hope it is clear. बच्चे दिख रहा है आपको अच्छे से? So you can note down. Okay, wait. Wait. Okay, I4. So here is the I4 at this end. So I1 greater than I2. I1 greater than I2, greater than I3. I3 से भी बड़ा है, but I3 and I4 की intensity same है, because they have the same current. So this is the relation for intensity for the question number 4. Relation for intensity. I hope you have noted down. अगर नहीं किया है नोट बच्चे यू कैन नोट डाउन. सो अप टू दिस पॉइंट इन द फर्स्ट 45 मिनट्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सम पॉइंट्स एंड फोर क्वेश्चंस विद इन थ्री पार्ट्स इन ईच क्वेश्चन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड. सो नाउ वी आर मूविंग टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 इज ऑन स्क्रीन. I hope you can try it. Firstly, try it for frequency. Try it for the frequency. Okay, you can try it for frequency. So frequency, kinetic energy is same for. So here you can see frequency is same. So frequency is same for the two radiations, 1 and 2. So that means frequency 1 is equal to frequency 2. Frequency 1 is equal to frequency 2 because these two have the same kinetic energy. That means they have the same incident energy. Now for 3 and 4, frequency 2 is greater than frequency 3. And this is equal to frequency 4. So I hope this is clear now. Frequency 1 equal to frequency 2. Frequency 2 greater than frequency 3. And frequency 3 is equal to frequency 4. So this is the relation for the frequency for the given question. Students, you can note down this one. This is the relation for the frequency of the given question. So this is graph is for the same one metal. This is for the one same metal. के एक metal के ऊपर हम क्या radiations को किस type से incident करते हैं और हमें क्या output मिलती है. So radiation one incident on the metal 2, 3, 4. तो ये characteristics बनती हैं. And from this characteristics, from these characteristics, we have to find the relation between frequency and wavelength and intensity. So I hope this frequency relation is clear for question number 5. Now we have to see the wavelength relation. So wavelength 1, frequency for first and 2 is energy for kinetic energy for 1 and 2 same, is that means incident radiation is same, that means lambda 1 equal to lambda 2. Now this has some more energy, so energy jada hai, that means lambda kam hai. So lambda 2 is less than lambda 3. And lambda 3 is equal to lambda 4. Lambda 3 and lambda 4 बच्चे equal होंगे because these have the same energy again. So lambda 3 and lambda 4. So this is the relation for the wavelength for the fifth question. Wavelength. So if you have any query for by you, then you can ask in the comment box or you can ask me personally. This is the relation for the wavelength. Lambda 1 equal to lambda 2 less than lambda 3 equal to lambda 4. Now we have to find the relation for the last question for the intensity. Now for intensity, the current is maximum for 1, 2 and 3 same, and for 4 it is less. So that means for intensity relation I1, intensity of 1 is greater than intensity of 2. I1 equal greater than I2. Equal to, because equal to will be used because Rajiv, photoelectric current for radiation 2 and 3 is same. So that means intensity of radiation 2 and intensity of radiation 3 is same. Then intensity of 3 is greater than intensity of 4. So intensity of 4 is lowest, because in this case the current is smallest. So I4 will be the smallest or lowest intensity. So I hope this relation is clear. I1 greater than I2, because यहाँ पे देखो बच्चे I1 का करंट ज़्यादा है, I1 करंट इज मोर एज कम्पेयर टू I2, एंड I2 एंड I3 करंट इज सेम. करंट फॉर रेडिएशन 2 एंड रेडिएशन 3 इज सेम, दैट मीन्स इंटेंसिटी ऑफ 2 एंड 3 इज नाउ सेम. आफ्टर दैट इंटेंसिटी 4, नाउ सी दिस वन 4. सो इंटेंसिटी फॉर 4 इज लोएस्ट, बिकॉज इन दिस केस करंट इज स्मॉलेस्ट. So I1 greater than I2 equal to I3 greater than I4 will be the answer for the intensity of given question. Intensity. Students, if any query is there, any doubt is there, then you can ask me personally. In the earlier video also I have discussed 4 questions. This is the intensity relation. So in the earlier video, that is okay, let me change first color. In the earlier video, 2 videos of this 7th unit are prepared, and this is the 3rd video, and one video is related to laws and one is related to photoelectric effect. And in the next video I will discuss some multiple choice questions. In the next video, some multiple choice questions will be there, and I will try. That video will be uploaded by Friday, a day after tomorrow. So some changes I have done in the background. Now the black background will be available. So agar achhi lage to bache feedback dena ki this background is better than white. And any suggestions if you want to provide, we have done 5 questions here. If in any question, if you have any doubt, then you can ask. एंड बाकी आपको कुछ लगे तो बताना. एंड दिस इज माई कॉन्टैक्ट नंबर दैट इज़ अवेलेबल एट द स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द वीडियो. सो दिस इज़ द माई कॉन्टैक्ट नंबर, यू कैन कॉन्टैक्ट मी एंड यू कैन गिव यूर वैल्यूएबल सजेशन ऑन दिस कॉन्टैक्ट नंबर. ओके, सो एनी सजेशन यू वॉन्ट टू गिव, यू कैन ड्रॉप अ मैसेज हेयर. एंड इट वॉज जसकीरत हेयर, and with the help of Mr. Sushil also, this content is developed. And rest of the things you know better than me. So thank you so much for watching this video, and have a nice day ahead, students. And for any doubts, for any queries, you can contact me here. So thank you so much, have a nice day ahead. Bye bye, take care, stay home, stay safe, stay healthy.